So what's going on, guys? Thank you so much for tuning into the Skate Informant. I missed you guys. Hope you guys missed me as well. Yes, it's true. This is not hashtag fake news. Forrest Edwards is officially skating for Zero Skateboards. The skate community was what these youngsters would call low-key shook when Zero posted this picture with the quote, Friday, meaning in a few hours. I can personally say that this is the best news in skateboarding / Zero in 2020 since the return of Chris Cole to Zero and Fallen. Now, if you're not exactly sure why this is such a huge deal, no worries, I'll explain. Over a decade ago, Slap Magazine, along with Amforce and Mountain Dew, put together a show called One in a Million. In the show, a group of talented yet under-recognized skateboarders, just as Mountain Dew described them, were recruited and taken to iconic skate spots and were to put their best skateboarding. Basically, a skateboarding reality TV show. While we saw bits and pieces of drama here and there, what really stood out was a young Forrest Edwards who was incredibly talented and had very confident and colorful statements to make. This shed a tremendous amount of light onto Forrest, which helped him rub shoulders with big companies, including Zero. Forrest started to hang around with the Zero crew, then rumors started to go around about them turning him pro, and then suddenly we see a sample board of Black Jesus. This was supposed to seal the deal. And then, out of nowhere, right before they went into mass production and consequently on sale, news came out he was no longer on Zero. Naturally, everyone wanted to know what happened, but no one wanted to speak out. Then, a year later, Jamie Thomas told the Ride Channel the inside scoop. So, directly extracted from the now non-existent Ride Channel's website with the Jamie Thomas interview, I quote, "His footage was all over the place and with a bunch of different people. When we finally got it all together, some of it had been used and he had tons of repeats and a lot of HD fisheye." Parenthesis. We have to remember that this was back in the day, so over 5 years ago. And back then, my only guess to Jamie's statement is he was looking for VX instead of HD. Again, those were different times. I know nowadays the acceptable formats have tremendously changed. I mean, just look at Nyjah's parts, for example. So yeah, back then, this didn't make a whole lot of sense. And having different formats, I mean, in any video just doesn't make sense, period. So that was probably what he was talking about. Closing parenthesis. So we didn't really have a part. He also only had one sequence for his interview. After 3 months of reminding him, we still didn't have an ad. So I sat down with him to try to discuss a plan, but he just shut down. It was too much pressure. I felt like it was going to be a never-ending headache. So I pulled the plug and told him it wasn't going to work out. End quote. So it wasn't a lack of talent and more so a lack of discipline and personality issues. According to Jamie's statements, meeting deadlines wasn't a strong suit on Forrest's end. After that, the world heard very little from Forrest. Until now. So why did he accept an obvious offer from Zero to ride for them after being dropped 5 years ago? What is happening Friday? A pro model? Will it be Black Jesus? Is he dropping a video part? All of the above? Will it be a 5-year video part? We don't know for certain, but time will tell. What we do know, however, is that we're very excited and happy to see Forrest with his new / reconciled family once again. Guys, this is the end of the video. Thank you so much for watching. If there are any other topics or subjects you would like for me to dive into and investigate for you, I would happily do so. Let me know in the comment section below. And like always, I am the Skate Informant. You've been informed. My job here is done. And I'll catch you guys on the next one.
Peace.